burden removal, power working of the Holy Spirit. Oh, but the key is that we have to allow. See, we can accept. Oh, you see, and all. But you have a choice. And I choose to rise up. And it's, God said, listen, now, you weak, I'll give you my strength. But you understand, he said, my grace is sufficient. And that means that whatever, it don't matter, whatever it is, provision has already been made. God's children are always conquerors. Dear Father, we honor you. Sometimes we feel like we're in this world. Oh, wow. Sometimes, Lord, it seems like that the world sits on top of you. And we know that we sit on top of the world. Because, God, you say you'll never leave us. And you'll never forsake us. God, my heart loves your people. And just want to encourage their hearts. Let them know, God, that they're more than conquerors. But it's so important, Lord, that they understand. It's a must, like never before, to stay in connection with you. Stay in prayer. Become a prayer warrior. That's how you communicate with the Father. By prayer. Everything God promised, he graced you with it. And Father, we want to say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
We give you all the glory, honor, and praise. And we say, Lord, wherever we have sinned, we keep short of your glory. We ask you for your forgiveness right now. In just now. Be glorified, Lord. Cleanse our heart. Cleanse our soul. Cleanse the body. Just cleanse us with the blood of you, Jesus. Nothing will ever be the same. You will always be glorified. And it's amen.
Amen.
It's blessing the Lord. Preached to people for years.
And all he could do was cry. That's why they talk about people crying.
Because other people so much.
And it's like, Lord, nobody's hearing me.
That's what they're hearing. And what's so glorious about everything is that
because Jeremiah preached because Jeremiah stood, even though I think Christians understand what we have, much as we want here.
Amen.
And God would judge you even greater.
Amen.
Because of the fact you have much, much of what? Much of His anointing, His word, His truth. Mm-hmm. But this is the good part about it. It's like the world had rejected Jeremiah. And all he was doing was telling the truth. But Lord, at the end, are you all listening to this wisdom?
Yeah.
At the end, all that hurt and suffering pain, it wasn't in vain. God had healed, delivered, and God set him free. And guess who set him free? The heathen king. The heathen king said, if 7 feet comes in, you know. The heathen king said, and you know what he said? The heathen king said this. Zedekiah, that was the king at the time. He said, there's a man that I heard. Y'all, your name has been heard.
Come on, y'all.
You're going to be so effective or efficient or sufficient and all this. Because the fact you are soldiers of the Lord, but back to Jeremiah, God talking to Bridge right now. A heathen king, hear this, baby. A heathen king said, because of the fact Jerusalem, you know, was divided in three different times. They just come out at once a month. He came in for the rich first. Then he came in for the middle class second. And then he came in for the poor people last. But you see, we're number one.
Amen.
I'm in the rich clan. I'm in the rich clan. Happy Mother's Day. I'm in the rich clan. Yeah, I'm in the rich clan. But watch this though. The heathen king said, I heard that there's a prophet. Now think about it now. He came in and destroyed Jerusalem on different occasions. It was three different stages. The first one, the second one, and the third one. And when the third one came, he said, anybody heard? He said, there's a man, they tell me this. Down there in Baton Rouge, her name is Bridget. And he said, and he asked the king, who, what's his name? He was talking to the king. Judah, he said, what's his name? And he said, Jeremiah. He said, what did Jeremiah tell you?
Ooh.
The prophet of the Lord. Hear ye the word of the Lord. God's calling your name. God's disturbing, and we decree and declare and prophesy that they sleep be so disturbed that they cannot rest until they obey God, thinking about virgin. Because this blessed me so much that the king said at the end, I love you. did. He said, anybody heard about this man? This angel. And he was talking to Zedekiah. He said, the devil had to call your name.
Yes, he did. Yes, he did.
Let me talk to somebody right here. The devil had to give you that money, whether he wanted to give it to you or not. The devil had to give you the position, whether he wanted to give it to you or not. The devil had to give you that raise, whether he wanted to or not. The devil had to lose your healing, whether he wanted to or not. The devil had to lose your deliverance, whether he wanted to or not. The devil, he couldn't see truth. So he was blinded for real.
Oh my God.
You know, some people just want to stay in their foolishness. Some people want to stay in their foolishness by choice. Some people just don't want to obey God. Some people just don't want to do right. Some people, but you got to leave them alone, just love them. And let God do the work. Are you, Lord, and bless me. I said, whoa. So then let me know that, well, this is my day. All right, y'all are here. I think it's not a Mother's Day I'm talking about. Even though I have a Mother's Day, but this is my day. This is my day. The Lord has spoken prophecy in my life. This is my day for it to be fulfilled. I don't know about it ever. If you had any wisdom in you, I said, Lord, she's talking to me. I said, Lord, I know you're talking to me. I said, Lord, you're talking to me. Lord, I know you're talking to me, Lord. Today is the day. This is my day. So as the prophet spoke, so shall it be. So as the prophet spoke, so shall it be. Whether they like it or not, whether they agree with the prophecy or not, this is what blessed me right here. I want you to understand, babies, that throughout the course of our lives, talking about human, there's only one race of mankind. Everybody said it's human. Say it again. Okay, it's human. Throughout the course of life, I want you to catch this now. There's a word that's called failure. In other words, each and all of us go through this stage. You know, that, but let me tell you something. You might think that because of the fact it didn't do what you thought it was supposed to have done for you. Am I saying that right?
Uh-huh.
But check this out though. Even though every mankind failed God, I'm going to say it again. Even though every mankind fails God, but God never failed at what he prophesied in your life. Y'all gonna hear this, what y'all gonna do? No matter what, you may have failed God, but I swore under the oath of the blood of Jesus, not one of his prophecies went undone.
Not one
of God. Catch the revelation. Yeah, I don't care how many times Peter and James. Oh, he had to get on Peter a lot of times. But guess what? Peter was the big boy in charge at the end.
Yes, he was.
Oh, you have to do somebody say stay connected with
that. Amen.
But this is what I want you all to understand today. No matter how many times you fall, get back up.
Amen.
I'm
going
to say that again. I don't care how many times you fall, how many times you disappoint God. You got to understand that mankind failed God. But God's word, the prophecy that he spoke in your life, that never fails. He may do a little rerouting, but baby, that detour is a good word to do. Yeah. The law, but the prophecy that he spoke in your life, honey, it's going to come to pass. It's got to, somebody say it has to come to pass
right now.
In my life. It has to come to pass right now. In my life.
Look at this.
Look at this
for a minute.
This morning, writing, right? Then the Lord began to say, remind them human weakness. Y'all, everybody had it. Y'all, it's human weakness. As long as, oh, thank you, Holy Ghost. How many of you all always hear people say, save my soul? Save my soul. What are you really talking about saving my soul? God can save you those for the time? What you're really telling God is that cleanse the imperfection that's in my soul. And that only can happen through by the word. It's the washing of the word. You see, because your spirit is already saved, regenerated, renewed, and reborn. It's called born again. You hear the Holy Spirit? So when you cry and say, Lord, save my soul, you're really telling God, Lord, the imperfection that lies within the soul is real. Lord, cleanse it by your blood. Oh! Cleanse it. Lord, I don't want to think like that. You got to say it out of your mouth. Lord, I don't want to think like that. Lord, that's not what I want to do. Lord, that's not what I want. Lord, I don't want to be a liar. I don't want to be this, that, and the other. But you got to say, Lord, even when you don't want him, you got to say, Lord, will me no more him. But look at this right here. Now, I want you to look at these different ladies, okay? Watch this here. You can bring me in. All I know, this is our day. All I know, the prophecies that are already being fulfilled. Now, I want you to look at this for a minute. Just look at it.
And then I
want to
tie it in with what God has
been
saying.
I want you to put up my baby girl, Matthew. That's what I want you. I want you to pull Matthew up, but I want you all to focus on something. Okay? Pull up Matthew from me where they were on the mountain. And it was Jesus, Elijah, and Moses. Oh, just hold tight right there. But look at this. It goes to your heart because of facts. Many times, you know, we haven't been grown all our lives, okay? And many times we have made our mother cry. Many times we have heard it, our mother, and we forget about that. You know? And we reject the kids, but you don't understand how many tears your mama prayed. Cried out and prayed for you. I knew my mama was a praying woman. And we forget so quick, like, you grew up overnight. You grew up overnight. You got to give people that room to grow. But look at this here. I don't care how you are, this is a prophecy of the Lord. I don't care how messed up you may think your life is, like in a show. I don't care how you may think. Everybody say think. Mm-hmm. You may think it's all in a show. You may think it's all just all scrabble up. You may think it. But God planned for you is to be good to virtue. I'm going to say that again. God planned for virtue is to be good to virtue. Can I tell you all something? The worst thing that you think that ever could happen in your life, and you may have to think that is, Lord, have mercy, Jesus, but can I tell you something? That's the most beautiful time of your life. Why? Because God is going to get greater glory. You be careful telling God, Lord, use me. Because of the fact your wife was just walking out the door on you. And you're like, Lord, I ain't say use me that way. But you told me to use you. Look at this, you're talking. Now, these are people. Now, we know Jesus has died for all of our sins. We know by the blood we've been washed and cleansed. We know all of these things, right? Yes, we do. But I want you to look at how something could be so messy. Like, ooh, messy. And just look like no good to be in that because it's too messy. I'm going to show you something. Israel was made up when Israel was made first, you know, that was Jacob's name, am I correct?
Yes.
And God changed his name to Israel, right? And out of that, he had 12 boys. All right? Okay? He had 12 boys. And they all did some crazy stuff. But God say, when I choose you, just chose. I mess you. Look, how it may look like the debris. It don't matter to God. Because if you look at tomorrow, now watch this now. These are women that you will look down on. But God's are all of his prestige.
Ooh.
Women, mothers. All of your God is saying prestige. Meaning he elevated you.
Amen.
Lifted you. And he has called you blessed. No matter what. Tamar was a woman. Her father-in-law was named Judah. And he had two sons. But those two sons died. And he made her a promise. When the oldest boy died, he said, I'm going to give you my younger boy. See, these generational blessings are true. He said, I'm going to give you my younger boy. So the younger boy died. So she was left. It was hard on a woman in those days, being a widow. Because of the fact she couldn't possess land and all this kind of stuff. Until later down in the time, Moses changed that. Because women went to him and like, you know, they didn't think it was fair. But anyway, this woman here, now I want you to see how Christ will come on the scene through a messy situation. I want y'all to hear that.
Come on.
that was not her husband. And he said, we need to know how to judge this thing. And we need to know what to do with this situation. And all but everybody came on one accord. Jesus, even the one that didn't realize that he was about to kill his own seed. What must we do? Kill her. Stone her. But she was a wise.
Come on now.
Look what she did.
I tell you what, you won't leave me homeless.
I tell you what, you won't leave me without.
So this is what she did.
She covered her face. And she said, Israelite. And that's who he was. He was Israelite. And said, you could come and lie with me. She said, and she covered her face up like this. She said, you could come and lie with me because I know you're tired. And I know you're weary. And I know about sexual healing. I heard Marvin Gaye say. And when she did that, she had her face covered. And guess what he did? Follow her. Follow her to her bedroom. Slept with the woman. The woman got pregnant. And when she got pregnant, watch this. When she got pregnant, they had a discussion about the woman. Now, all they can say, people forget easy. You can do good all your life, but make one mistake, you never done nobody. And after the meeting, they said, what's that? She said, oh. We're gonna stone him. Now give me the stick. And while Judah, remember everybody say Jacob. Say it again.
Jacob.
Gotta understand. Jacob's name was changed to what? Alright, So Judah was sleeping because of the fact she was supposed to be stoned. The next day, because he had already had the meeting, right? So, it's the same woman. She told him when he slept with her, she said, leave me something that I would know you would return it back with my money. Oh, yeah, it's biblical.
Yes, it is.
It's biblical.
Yes, it is.
My Bible says, so when Judah was asleep, she quietly creeped in his little sleeping area. And she laid his own rod. Oh, in other words, that same thing the devil meant to take you away from gonna end up blessing you. You got to hear the prophecy of the Lord. Gonna end up. And don't worry about nothing. Because God got you not only on his mind, but he got you in his heart. And my Bible said the woman creeped in. Anyway, she lived beside him. And he said, when he realized it, she said he had to call this, had to call the same mom.
How y'all hear
me?
Had to call the same mom. Had to come back and have a meeting and discuss. Now watch this now. They was gonna kill her.
Well, why you wouldn't kill Julie? He slept with her. Check this out, you go. But here it is now. How is it that a whore is no more after today. Yeah. Thus says the Lord. And we have the word. Give me it. We have the word, the prophet. Oh, y'all, now listen.
Come on now.
What?
All right, give it up. Now, here it is now. And these boys said, now, it was so bad during that time because it was a wall of Jericho that was up.
Uh-huh.
And baby, nobody couldn't get through the wall of Jericho.
No.
Only the supernatural power of God could rain down the miracles in your life the way he did. I don't know about you, but I'm taking it personal. Only the supernatural power of God could rain down. Come in. Built that no human could penetrate through. But you can't keep God out. hold on. Because the shout getting ready to go. The shout getting ready to just come in. The shout, somebody say a shout. The shout getting ready to go. They told me to shout and repeat. Run the horn and shout. Run the horn, give me praise. Run the horn, give me glory. Run the horn, give me honor. Run the horn and give me prayer. Walk around and pay for it. 7 days, Lord of God. 7 times, Lord of God. Walk around and pay for it. And watch my power move. And watch my power tear down. Watch my power knock the ground.
Hold on to the promises of God.
understand the power of the blood.
Hallelujah.
I apply the blood over my mind. That's what you have to put everything. I apply the blood over my mind, my spirit, and my body. I apply the blood. I say, Lord, I know one thing, Lord. I know I can't ask you to increase my faith, but I can ask you to protect my faith. Because, Lord, it's going to take faith to get me where you told me I'm going and where I have to get to. Y'all going to get a hold of it. And my mom said, blah, 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 blah. And with that whore, had that red cord coming up. And I look, how is it that this whore ended up becoming the mother of boys?
Come on.
Wow.
Amen. Y'all, what y'all going to do with this?
See, that's what you look at like it's so evil. What's good just come to it. What's good just gonna turn something around. What's good? Tell your neighbor, what's good? Come to your house. Tell somebody, what's good? Come to your house. She married, watch this now. She was a Canaanite. Prostitute. Somebody.
Come on. Come on here.
She said, you'll never have a poor day. She said, I'm going to give you some wisdom how to do it. Don't throw yourself on it. You don't have to show all your boobs. You don't have to show all your backside. You ain't going to do that to get a man. See, a real man looking for a real woman. And a real woman knows how to cover herself up. And a real woman knows, oh, my God, it's true. A real woman. She don't have to. What a real man wants all, but he won't expose. They want a real woman. But can't nobody see it but him. They can't nobody praise it but him. Can't nobody look at it but him. And if they were so good about it, the reason why it's so powerful, because in fact you always want what you can't get. So if you give it up too easy, you're going to become somebody they're going to use up, because it's always the weaker one. I said, what they call it, the weakest one, the weakest link. And all they're going to do is say, shoo, I can't give it that. She too loose. Is that what it's called? No, you want it, you're gonna wait on it. If not, you gonna say, if you really, really want to put a ring on it. God, you just keep moving, dude. And then the next one here is Ben. You tell Shirley Shepherd she got one more time to miss church because of the fact what she's doing, she's leaving a post. Let me talk about the Holy Ghost. That's Keith's wife. She got one more time to leave her post empty. And God said to tell her, I'm going to deal with you. You would be a God assign you to a post and you just walk away like it ain't nothing, but you'll come back when you think you want to come back. No, it don't work like that. It don't work like that. That's his wife and my sister, and God don't play with us. You got a post to stand in. How you gonna leave some? How is the word that look like you just leave your post? And you just leave where the enemy can come at that. But this baby trying to do it all by herself. But God said, tell her, do it one more time, you're going to deal with her.
Amen.
And he ain't playing with her neither.
Amen.
Bathsheba, verse Solomon. Son of David. Mary, a descendant of David. These women had purpose because the Messiah. If you just think about it, because the Messiah had to get here. And these people are as myself, because we are all people. For some strange reason, I can see what you do, but I can't see what you do. What is this called? Human. But you can correct that though. And you can get it right. Close it off. Now, you've already heard what God said from the word, the prophecy of the Lord has been spoken. You already said it there. God said, listen, I'm making this a connection. I hear the word connection. He's connecting you. He's connecting you. Wherever it is, whoever it is, it's connected to you. You think that you're just walking and going in that way, but no, that's God doing what he's doing, and you don't realize it. And when God do it, you're like, man, it was God. I'm so glad I came. I'm so glad I obeyed God. I'm so glad. So here you go. The Bible says this. After 6 days, and the Holy Ghost went out of off of, he said, tell them this way, everybody who have an authority to hold down that post.
Amen.
deal with every last one of them.
Amen.
Like a cake that important. I ain't barbecue, not that important. After 6 days, Jesus took with him Peter, James, and John, the brother of James, and led them up a high mountain by themselves. Come on in. There he was
Moses and Elijah
his disciples on a natural level. Because before the death, burial, and resurrection took place, nobody was filled with the Holy Ghost.
Nobody's
heart had a transformation.
Nobody.
All you could do before the blood was shed. Before the blood was shed. Nobody's heart was changed.
Nobody
had eternal life. Before he, death, burial, resurrection, and rise up. Before the blood was shed. Nobody had hope. But when the blood got shed, the whole world turned around. The whole effect of the universe, the elements, everything shook. Why? Because Jesus shook everything around in your life. Shook it off for you, give all this. Shook it off. Shook everything. Everything is everything on you. Boy, in the name, Son of God, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord, shake it all, Lord, shake it off for this, Father. Every demonic force, every evil spirit, every load of us, every spirit of darkness, every Lord, the mighty force of the Lord, every evil empty, every high, deep in the high place. Oh Lord God, I pour every last one down in the name of Jesus. I pour it down, Lord God, every dark force, every evil force, every word of the Lord, every word of the darkness, every Lord, the force, the Lord, evil, but Lord, I cry in the name of Jesus. Reverse that curse over my child.
Yes, Lord.
Give him a pill of God, give him peace to his mind because the enemy trying to mess with my baby. I come in the name of Jesus. Come in the name of Jesus. Cursing every work that enemy thought to rise up against you with in the name of Jesus Christ. And you go down and say, bring it back to them, to John. Go back down. And he fell on his face and cried.
Terrified.
Shaking.
Uh-huh.
Have anybody ever experienced the presence of God? And tears just come out of your body. Tears just come out of your
body.
Go back up, I think, to the second verse. I want them to see Elijah. Pastor Pete talked about this. Moses and Elijah was in the grave. All right, get this done. Look at the connection. Watch this done. Moses was the lawgiver. Elijah was the prophet. Became the prophet to fulfill the law. All right, I didn't catch her. Christ the prophet, because Elijah was a prophet. Moses was a lawgiver. Look, everything that Moses talked about, Christ came and fulfilled it. And then Moses and Elijah talking with. Close your eyes for a second. Now open your eyes back up. Whatever you thought and believe God for, God has given you a preview of what's to come. It's been proven by the word prophesied. He didn't use it of the people who you thought he was going to use. He went and got some folks that wasn't going to touch his glory. And all the praise was going to be given to God. That's why Elijah looks so nasty, so messy. And if you hear about that we talk about today, not a one of these women, they wasn't Jews. Close your Bibles. He said just then that y'all got to understand this. Close your Bible. Everybody said just then.
Just then.
Say it again.
Just then.
Say it again.
Just then. You're getting ready to encounter.
lost sight to this earth. You want to see that the prophet has already, according to my Bible says that the prophet Jesus has already fulfilled the law of Moses. So if the prophet Jesus fulfilled the law of Moses, that means that now the New Testament had to come forth, or should I say, out of the Old Testament, the New Testament has come forth now. You're not living under the law anymore. You're living under grace. It's so pretty. Child up to now. You see, when you get in a rush to get out of his presence, he's going to take his time getting to you what you have. When you want to rush to get out of God's presence, I can't remember not one time that the DJ had to tell me to stay on the floor. If anything, I'm telling the DJ, why you turn it down? And we just like it. Turn it off for what? Y'all understand, like last time you said, yeah. If you haven't given Christ your life, this is the time. This is what grace out of your life. If you haven't given Christ your life, this is the greatest time. Facebook family, God love you. Means you love, God loves you.
Hallelujah.
God love you. Every word that's been spoken out of God's mouth today, not one word will fall to the ground. God's hands is really holding you. God got you. But if you are not saved, everybody, repeat after me, one or two now. I say, Lord,
Lord,
I come to you,
I come to you
with all my heart,
with all my heart,
asking you, Lord,
asking you, Lord,
to forgive me,
forgive
of all my sins,
of all my sins,
known,
known
and unknown.
And unknown.
Lord, forgive me.
Lord, forgive
thank you, Lord,
thank you, Lord,
for the cleansing,
for the cleansing
and the washing of your blood, that cleansed my heart,
cleansed
my soul.
God,
I thank you.
It
just sets me free.
And
I'm free indeed.
And
I give you praise.
And
I give you glory.
And
I give you honor.
I
thank you, Lord.
Because
you said if I believe that Jesus Christ died for my sin, that I may live eternally in the presence of my Father. You told me out of your own mouth, I shall be saved. And for that alone, God, thank you for salvation. Thank you for saving us, Lord. Thank you. I don't care. It don't matter who you are. God love you. You may be dealing with all types of issues. It don't matter. You may be dealing with gay issues, or you may be dealing with worry issues, depression issues, oppression issues, or whatever infirmity. You may be, it don't matter. It don't matter. See, God don't discriminate when it comes down to his love. God ain't telling nobody to change nobody. He said, but I command you to love everybody.
Amen.
And people get it mixed up because of the fact they want to hug and embrace and love the one that they want. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, give me some more, baby. And in the name of the Holy Spirit, washing of your blood.
Thank you.
I thank you for the cleansing of your blood. I thank you for the grace of forgiveness. I thank you for, Lord, the life of love. I thank you, Lord, to see your life of peace. I thank you, Lord God, for the love, God, that surpasses all our understanding. And Lord, you overlook faults and you always see a need. Now, Lord, this is your son, but you're gracious to be in my care because he's in your care. Now, Lord, something happened, baby Gary. God is with you. God is with you. You're going to see God do some things in your life. That people would excuse you. They just would have like, whatever, pass you up. But God, in your life, you're going to encounter the glory of the Almighty God. And to you, O Father, be thou glorified in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Ghost. And the Lord called it done. In Jesus' name, amen. And amen. Everybody bless the Lord. Keep her lifted up. Lord, I thank you, Lord, that all my children are covered, and they are covered with the blood of Jesus. Now, Lord, I thank you, and I say to you, my Father, be thou glorified in the name of Jesus Christ. And we say that it is so, and it's amen, and amen. Bless the Lord with a hand clap of praise. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and the name of the Holy Spirit. It is so. Amen. And amen. Come on, y'all. Love on my baby.